Hello, my name is Arman Kian, and I'm excited to present some highlights from our recently published article in Allergy, Unsupervised Clustering Reveals Intestine-Adapted Eosinophil Subsets Shaped by Local Inflammation. Steady-state intestine-resident eosinophils are instrumental in maintaining metabolic, tissue, and immune homeostasis. This is in sharp contrast to apparent pathologic functions of subsets of eosinophils within the context of eosinophil-associated diseases. In line with an emerging recognition of functional phenotypes of tissue eosinophils, recent studies have reported intestinal subsets. For example, CD11C was identified as an early marker of intestinal adaptation that exhibits an increasing continuum of expression over time and in parallel with migration into villi. A PD-L1 CD80 double positive population exhibits antimicrobial and immune modulatory effects. CLEG4A4 identifies a subset with an immune regulatory transcriptome and enriched expression of PD-L1. And, most recently, a villus-restricted immunoregulatory subset of CD22-positive eosinophils that also expressed CLEG4A4 was reported. A unified reconciliation of these separately reported subsets is lacking. Also lacking is an understanding of how local inflammation shapes these phenotypes, a comprehensive understanding of their divergence within and across inflammatory states, and ultimately their relationship, if any, to homeostatic versus pathologic potentials of intestinal eosinophils. These are gaps we sought to bridge in this study. To unify and reconcile reported subsets across health and disease, we isolated lamina propria cells from whole small intestines of healthy wild-type mice, food allergen challenge mice, and TNF delta area mice that exhibit spontaneous ileitis. We performed targeted multidimensional flow cytometry followed by unsupervised clustering to generate TSNE plots and compared expression patterns of individual receptors overlaid onto these plots. We used CD11C as a primary indicator of intestinal adaptations. Among total eosinophils across all conditions, PD-L1 and CD80 exhibited the highest degree of co-localization with CD11C. Thus, identifying CD11C, PD-L1, and CD80 co-expression as a core surface receptor signature that identifies intestine-adapted eosinophils irrespective of inflammatory status. We confirmed the CD11C, PD-L1, CD80 intestine-adapted subset in a separate cohort of mice and demonstrated their spatial distribution, revealing decreasing frequencies of the intestine-adapted phenotype among eosinophils along the length of the small intestine, with their near absence in the colon of healthy wild-type mice. We observed divergences in TSNE expression patterns when comparing intestine-adapted eosinophils from healthy versus inflamed mice that closely aligned with expression or absence of the inhibitory C-type lectin CLEG4A4. Among intestine-adapted eosinophils, CLEG4A4 expression was highly enriched in healthy mice with an approximately 90% overlay, while this population was nearly absent in the context of ileitis, overlaying with only 12% of intestine-adapted eosinophils. CLEG4A4 binds glycan ligands, including N-glycans expressed on CLEG4A4 itself, transmitting a suppressive signal that in other cell types has been shown to dampen activation. Therefore, it's possible that CLEG4A4 restrains activation-induced processes such as cytolytic degranulation in this subset of eosinophils. To directly explore a role for the tissue microenvironment in shaping phenotypes in vivo, we used BRDU pulse labeling. As expected, ilia of TNF delta area mice were inflamed relative to the wild-type littermates and elicited increased infiltration of the BRDU-positive eosinophils. In both wild-type and ileitis mice, BRDU-positive eosinophils rapidly adopted the adaptation signature of CD11C, PD-L1, and CD80. However, while CLEG4A4 was uniformly induced on newly adapted eosinophils in wild-type mice, approximately 30% failed to express CLEG4A4 within the context of active ileitis, underscoring the important role of the local tissue environment. In summary, we provide a comprehensive rendering of small intestinal eosinophil phenotypes that reconciles recent, separately reported intestinal eosinophil subpopulations and reveal rapid effects of the local tissue microenvironment in shaping intestinal adaptations in vivo. Further functional studies are pending to evaluate the potential restraining function of CLEG4A4 in the context of disease and inflammation. This study has important implications for eosinophil-associated intestinal diseases, including opening the door to more nuanced histopathologic assessments of eosinophil subsets to guide therapy, in consideration of novel therapeutic interventions that seek to modulate eosinophil phenotypes. Thank you.